Listener discretion is advised. Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
LoveLine, coast to coast.
Hey, what's going on? Geez, Jerome, this close to dropping trow. This close to dropping
20 seconds into the show, that's
gonna drop trow. Hey, it's LoveLine, everybody. 1-800-LOVE-191. That's Dr. Drew, board-certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. Anderson, is something not mixed right or something tonight?
No, I think it's your congestion, your sinuses.
No congestion. Please turn that music down, if that's what you kids are calling it. All right. It is me. It is Drew. We is doing the show tonight. We don't have a guest. Oh, thank God. No host hates their guests as much as I do.
Jack was fun. Jack Osborne was fun the other night, though, right?
Yeah. It's really, to me, the guest is one of the, it's sort of like working out. You don't look forward to it. You even dread it. Then when you're done, you kind of feel better.
Right.
You broke a sweat. You learned something.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, Jack Osborne was great on Thursday. And I look forward to all future guests, except for the ones that come to the show.
Sabrina?
Yeah.
You're 16. Hold on. It just really, I am so lazy that part of my job is to interview a guest. Yeah. And when the guest doesn't show up, hey, I got a better night.
It's easier for you.
It's easier.
Yeah.
That's how lazy I am.
You can just sit here and talk about nothing, like you normally do.
Yeah.
We were at breakfast the other morning. Adam went on about how he just talks about nothing. And I said, yeah, hear. yeah, back me up.
Thank you.
That's nice.
Sabrina?
I didn't know you were aware of that.
You're 16?
Yes.
What's up?
I can't orgasm, basically.
Mm-hmm. Have you never had one?
I've had one, and it was the first time I had anal sex.
No. You were 9?
What?
How old were you?
16.
16?
Yes.
And you've had orgasms in your life before, right?
One, yes.
Just that one?
Yes.
Never masturbated or anything like that?
Never got off, never even cummed while masturbating.
What's actually the technical difference between coming and orgasm?
Well, I don't know. It just it felt different. Like okay.
I imagine anal sex different. Adam, would you?
No, I can.
Here. Yeah, it's different.
I know anal sex is different, but I mean, orgasming and coming, because like I don't know. I can't even basically come. I can if I'm on top. Like I feel it.
Hold on, are you making a distinction between orgasming and coming?
What do you mean?
That's what she's doing, yes.
Distinction meaning a difference between the two?
The words mean exactly the same thing.
Okay.
But you have some sort of, in your head, a distinction there.
Well, then I can only orgasm when I'm on top.
Okay. Then that's fine.
That's way ahead of the average 16-year-old. Most 16-year-olds cannot orgasm during intercourse.
Really?
Yes, really.
I did not know that at all.
That's true.
Yes, it is true.
Also, now you know that.
Turned into a computer. Turned into the robot, the maid from the Jetsons.
Jaime. Right, was that his name?
Yeah, Jaime the robot. All right, hey, Sabrina.
Yes.
Do you have a boyfriend?
Yes.
Is he a good guy?
Sometimes.
How old is he?
17. He has a lot of problems.
What kind of problems?
Miss Pepe? Do you want to go into this?
No, I just worry about you. Hey, actually, right, I know.
Well, I'm worried about her. She gives us that special feeling. That she's a little out of control, a little...
Yeah.
Unsupervised.
Okay, so Sabrina needs not to get pregnant.
Right.
That's really what she needs to do,
it's
right?
Number 1, 2, and 3 recommendations for her.
But you know what it's like? It's World War II, it's Vietnam, it's one of these huge conflicts that's happening somewhere overseas, and your child is leaving, and he's in the infantry, and he's going to the front lines. You don't get a bruise, don't get a scratch.
That's right. Don't get killed.
Don't get killed.
Yeah.
That's the message of this show. Except for we're not saying don't get killed.
We're saying don't have kids.
Yeah, we're not saying that there's not going to be a crab or two given... That you're not going to get a wart or a herpes, that there's not going to be a tear or two shed. But we're saying, let's not make it cataclysmic. Don't kill yourself, don't put a gun in your mouth, and don't get anyone pregnant.
In a way, we're giving kind of the opposite advice of the mom talking to her child going off to war, right? So don't get killed, we're like, don't create life.
Don't create life. That's right. Yeah. plain Jesus, either way you look at it. Lauren?
Yeah.
You're 14?
Yeah.
What's up?
I was recently raped 14 times.
Good times.
What does that mean, 14 times? I mean, like...
Like 14 individual times.
In the one evening or one...
Yeah, like...
Or somewhere or something?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
What? Who did this?
Strangers.
More than one person?
Yeah. 14 different people.
How did
14
they...
14 different people?
Yeah.
Are you... Well, now, wait a minute. We got... This is another one of those don't get killed calls. How long ago did this happen?
It was in May.
May?
Yeah.
Did you get any diseases or anything? Have you been checked?
Yeah, but I was just wondering, like, what are my chances of, like, getting AIDS?
Well, you've not been checked for that?
I have, but they told me every 3 months I have to keep getting it checked.
That's good. Were any of these people drug addicts?
All of them were.
All of them were drug addicts?
Yeah.
Well, what happened?
Oof. What's the story, yeah?
Well, basically, I ran away with a friend, and we ended up in the city, and these people found us on the street, and they basically kidnapped us for 4 days.
14 guys kidnapped
yeah.
you? For
yeah.
4 days?
Who were these people? Who were they?
Jehovah's Witness.
Who?
Strangers. We didn't even know them.
But I mean, were they a gang or something? Or
yeah.
Who?
14 guys. So, yeah. like, they pulled up in a couple of cars?
They were, like, hanging out, like, at a corner. And we were passing them, and they basically pulled us, and they told us to come with them, or else they'd kill us.
So, you and your friend?
Yeah.
How'd you get away?
Huh?
How'd you get away?
Well, after they were done with us, a guy dropped $20, and I took and ran to a bus, and we got on the bus and went home.
Have a friend?
She went with me.
You could see a bus out the window or something?
Yeah.
Why didn't you just run such as it was?
Huh?
Why weren't you just running away anyway? Why did you have to wait for the bus?
Because they had weapons, and they threatened to kill us. And they went inside to go get something, like, in a market, and then we saw the bus, and we ran across the street and got on it.
So they weren't watching for a few minutes?
Right.
Ooh. Hold on a second. The guy dropped $20 and said, yeah, well, you guys ride the horse in front of the market.
No, he dropped it. Like, somebody left one behind, money behind by accident.
She said he dropped it.
She saw somebody drop money. She grabbed
one
it.
Of the gang members.
Yeah,
guys.
Grabbed the money.
Well, they headed into the market and just left them out front kind of thing?
Well, just keep asking. It's kind of an amazing story.
It is.
I don't think it's made up.
Oh, I don't think it's made up either, but it's... There's something else.
Something missing, yeah. Yeah,
yeah, because in a minute we're going to find out that these guys were never prosecuted and we never went to the cops or something like that. And then it gets really weird.
So you reported these guys?
Yeah.
Did they find them?
They found one and one's in jail right now.
For what he did to you?
Yeah.
He is?
Yeah.
And your friend got away on the same bus?
Yeah.
What happened to all the other 14 guys, 13 guys?
They're in the process of putting them in jail.
Really? And did you testify? Did they have a trial?
Yeah.
How did you say they get in jail without your...
Another girl was involved who got money for every guy who had sex with me, she got money for. And she's the one that said, yeah, this happened, and that's how they knew that.
Is she the one that sort of tricked you into getting...
Right.
Wow.
And did they keep... So they kept you, like, locked up in a room or something?
No, they basically had at least 2 guys watching us at all times.
Wow.
And for 4 days, we were watched, and just, it was a mess. And he raped me.
How have you dealt with this since then?
I've been in therapy.
Yeah?
And that's
it. Are you on medication?
Yeah.
What are you taking?
Zoloft.
You're doing okay? You able to function?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Why were you running away in the first place?
Because I was having problems with my dad.
What kind of?
A control freak.
Okay. How are things now with your dad?
Well, I don't live with him now.
All right. You're not waking up in the middle of the night with this?
I used to. It was nightmares.
Wow.
How's your friend doing?
I don't talk to her anymore.
Wow.
Jesus.
Well, right. I think you should count your blessings. You survived something unbelievable.
Blessings.
No, I mean, to have survived this and not been... I think these people were going to kill her, I'm sure. Of course.
I don't know.
Why not? How much further they got to... You know what I mean?
They were
kidnapping, rape, multiple... I mean,
no,
imprisonment. I mean,
they're bad guys, but the security was definitely a little lax. I mean, they're like out in front of a store and they all went in and just left them outside.
They're drug addicts.
All right, drug addicts.
And then you're getting treatment, things are stable, the probability of AIDS, you've been checked with several times, right? It happened in May, it was from May, June, July, August.
Why wouldn't they get her on the cocktail immediately?
Good question. Did they offer you antiviral medication right away?
Yeah.
Did you do that?
Yeah.
She did it.
All right.
So there you go.
Well, Lauren, you're fine.
Lauren, I think it's going to be okay.
Physically, you'll be fine. It's just, you know, emotionally, I have to stay with the therapy and everything, all right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, take care of yourself.
Is there anything
right?
you can tell other folks who are thinking about running away? Maybe your story has some sort of...
Just don't do it. It's the wrong decision.
And just say something. Obviously, it's the wrong decision for you, but can you help people understand what reality is of getting out there? I mean, how different it felt when you thought about doing it opposed to what happened when you did it?
It was totally different. I didn't think any of this would happen. I thought I was going to go out and have fun, you know, party for a couple of days and go home.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, sorry this happened to you.
But thanks for calling.
Mm-hmm.
Take care of yourself, all right?
Thank you.
All right. Well, she's none the worse for wear.
Wow.
You're kidding. I'd go nuts. I couldn't imagine. I mean, if half of what she told us is true, this is five tours in Vietnam.
Look, I get post-traumatic stress symptoms every time the damn space shuttle lands.
Yeah,
get the
I know.
Boom, I've had panic attacks for 3 days.
Drew hears a sonic boom, he cramps himself.
He'll get to that.
Oh, yeah.
As I get older.
It's number one now, but with about 3 years.
Yeah.
Allie?
Hey.
Hey, you're 14. What's up?
Okay. This is my thing. I have a boyfriend. Kind of. Yeah. And we had sex once. And, the thing is, he didn't call for, 2 weeks after that, you know? And finally, until my friend was, begging me, oh, you should call him and stuff like that. So I called him, and then he's like, oh, hey, you should come over to my house and stuff.
Uh-oh.
And I'm thinking, you know, that he just wants me for that.
That's what he wants you for. How old is this guy?
He's 17.
This is why 17 or 14 is not a good mix. The 17-year-old's head is in a different place. Really, it is.
Yeah, you say this guy's her boyfriend? What is this guy to you?
It's her boyfriend.
Well...
Yeah, your boyfriend wants you to come over.
Yeah.
So is that what's going on?
Yeah.
How long has he been your boyfriend?
Not that long, actually.
How long?
A month.
A month. How many times have you seen him?
Very few, actually. Two or three times.
Two dates.
Two dates.
One of them was sex. Then no call for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If we talked to him, what do you think he would say the relationship
who?
Is?
Who?
Yeah.
Okay.
Allie,
well,
who?
It's not like he's always asking me about it. It's just he's trying to urge me into asking him.
For what?
You know?
For sex?
Yeah.
Listen, is everyone's line sound crappy tonight?
It's a bad sound night.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Is it all in my head?
Mostly.
Everyone sounds like they're in a speakerphone.
Well, that one was bad.
They're in a speakerphone in like a bathroom.
Yeah.
Okay. This guy may not be your boyfriend. Do not give him any more sex. Big difference between 14 and 17.
This is it. This is that difference right here. Her perception of what this relationship is entirely different than his.
And this, by the way, as I've said many times on the show... that this whole strategy of opening up high schoolers to ninth graders, essentially people who are 14 the entire school year, doesn't seem like a great plan because when you're in high school and you're a junior, there's nothing wrong with you dating a ninth grader and you can be 17.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying there, Drewska?
Right.
All right, buddy. Let's, thank God your kids go to school with no grades in every grade, right?
The kindergartners are mixing with the 12th graders, yes.
Really?
Of course.
Jesus Christ. I told you I found out my, one of my...
Uh-oh.
You know, I'm such a prick on the radio, but it's hard not to be one in real life.
I hadn't noticed you trying not to be one.
I try not to.
You do a good job of making it look easy.
I try not to, but I mentioned this before, but it just reminded me, we were talking about school. I have three little... step nieces, sweet, pretty little girls. Like they're 8, 11, and 13 or something. And one of them, I don't know, it's like the 13-year-old, was student body president of her high school.
A Corolla? It's not a Corolla.
Oh, no.
No.
But I couldn't get over it. I was like, she must have been 14. I was like, what grade are you in? She's ninth grade. What is the school? 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th? And you're student body president?
No.
Yep. Really?
No, she means president of the class.
No, she was like student body president. I was like, are you serious?
How does that work?
Really? I mean, ninth grade, that's it's an amazing achievement. I mean, it's unthinkable that you would be student body president. I was like, how many kids in your school? 86. I was like, that includes all 9th, 10th, uh-huh. And I was like, all right.
Got it.
Keep the smile on the face. Keep nodding. Keeping the same. You know, I want to stand up and start screaming. That's all right. This is what I'm talking about. This is why, 86, you got, there's 14 and a half kids in each grade. All right. Now, that's something else. No one else wanted to do it. I didn't want to get bad. I'm just saying that the answer became clear to me. This thing
as it always does.
Could not get past. Yeah. Yes. All right. So let's talk to Jesse, who's 25. Jesse.
Hi.
What's up?
I've been kind of taking Vicodin a lot since April. Mm-hmm. Late April, I hurt my back really bad, and the doctor first prescribed me Vicodin.
What were you doing?
I got thrown into a curb.
What happened?
A big guy threw me into a curb.
Why'd he do that?
Because he was an a-hole.
Well, tell us a little. Give us a little.
Oh, shut up. Yeah. Sit on hold for a while, and then I'll talk to you later. Got thrown into a curb. Why? Guy did it. Why? He's an a-hole. Just walking down the street, ran to an a-hole, threw her into the curb. And listen, I know the guy's an a-hole, but what the story?
What happened?
Yeah, there was a little fight in front of a club, a little scuffle. He came up behind me, thought he was his ex-girlfriend.
He's an asshole is the answer to what's up with a guy that would do something like that to you. I don't know, he's an a-hole. But not what happened. What happened is what happened.
I know. Hey, Jesse?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hang out on hold for a while, all right? Yeah. You're 25, for Christ's sake.
Okay, they jumped my...
Up.
Come on, let's get it.
All right. What happened?
Hello?
What happened?
They jumped my boyfriend, so I jumped in.
Uh-huh. And would they just jumped him to get his money?
No. There was just a scuffle before, and
why?
Then when I saw them...
Why was there a scuffle?
I can't really talk about it. It's still, like, going through, like, police stuff.
No, that's all right. We'll accept
your
that.
Your boyfriend may be part a-hole, too.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah. Am I right?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. So
there you go.
You're addicted.
So you jumped in, and someone shoved you, and you hit the curb.
And you're now addicted to Vicodin. So what's up?
Yeah. I don't have any left. Like, my mom was giving me Lortab after that.
Listen, you need to get your addiction treated. This is the deal here. Vicodin should never be used more than a couple of weeks. And if you're driven to use it after that, you'll get these crushing back pains and leg pains and headaches. That's all Vicodin withdrawal.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to get this treated.
Okay, because initially it was the back. And then, like, this morning I woke up and my back was in excruciating pain.
That's withdrawal. The crushing pain, that's withdrawal.
Yeah.
And in the morning, because it's been a long time.
Yeah.
12 hours.
What about, sleeping? Like, having a hard time sleeping?
You'll feel agitated. You'll feel like jumping out of your skin. You'll have crushing boning. You'll feel depressed, like you've lost some important.
How about getting on the juice, Drew?
And you'll feel...
What's wrong with getting on the juice?
What, heroin?
No, get a little booze.
Well, that's what people do. They switch to other drugs.
All right.
They switch to other things.
And what about, like, OxyContin and alcohol? Is that a bad combination? I mean, I'm not taking those, but...
Fantasy answer.
I was just wondering about those, too.
It's delightful.
It's good for you. Vitamin O and vitamin E?
It's like taking wheatgrass and a multivitamin.
OxyContin, these are profoundly addictive opiates. It's heroin. You're a heroin addict.
I know, but listen, all you people who are now thinking, oh my God, this is going to be great, heroin in a tablet... I've taken this Vicodin before.
No, OxyContin you've never taken.
I haven't taken the OxyContin.
I've probably taken one of those.
No, you've never taken that.
You would have said that. Look, if I said I'd taken OxyContin and never taken Vicodin, you would have switched it to Vicodin.
No, OxyContin's much stronger. It'll knock you on your keister.
No. And what about the difference
Between
Vicodin and hydrocodone?
It's a Lortab. Look.
Look, hydrocodone, Vicodin, Lortab, all the same thing.
It is, because my boyfriend took some hydrocodone and he got really sick the next day off of it, but he can take the Vicodin and he's okay.
It's exactly the same thing. Something else was making him sick.
So what, look, Lortab's the same as the Vicodin?
Yeah, it just comes in adjusted doses. That's really the only difference. Listen, Jesse.
Lortab sounds like a pastry that comes out of it. It just seems like a pay, like you want some Lortabs, or do you want to go? You want to go Hostess? You want the Tasty Cakes? It's a pre-pack. There's Susie Q.
Right.
Next Susie Q, the Hostess, and the Tasty Cakes, and the Lortabs.
Got it.
I like
Lortab, Anexia, Vicodin are all hydrocodone. It's all that's in them, and acetaminophen, Tylenol.
Yeah.
But Jesse, listen, you're describing this is no effing around. It's a serious addiction you've got. You've got to get that treated. This is a catastrophe in evolution here. And you wait and see if you want to keep riding it out further.
Now, so OxyContin's a pain relief too, right?
Yeah, it's a long-acting Percocet, basically.
I'll tell you, I'm intrigued by this OxyContin. I'd like to try that out, Drew. You know, just to be able to... It's important for me to try these things because then I can describe to the listeners over the air not to do it.
Right, of course.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, part of my job here is like a restaurant critic.
That or a taster?
Yeah, I need to go out and sample all the local and various cuisines in order to report back to my large constituency. You understand?
I understand.
Okay.
Here we go.
Want to take a little break?
Yeah.
Neighbor kidnapped and raped her at age 3. Parents don't know he raped her.
Kidnap night.
All right, we'll take a little break. We'll be back with more hijinks after this. Hey, everybody, it's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. All righty. Let's hop back to the phones and speak to Emily, who's 16. Emily?
Hey.
Hey.
How you guys doing?
Good.
Wow. Emily?
Yeah.
Age 3.
Huh?
It's interesting.
Do you hear that?
Yeah.
Hold on a second, Emily. Okay. What Drew's alluding to for not only Emily, but all our listeners, is Emily's 16 years old, but she was, says up on the screen, kidnapped by her neighbor and raped at age 3. Yes?
Yeah, 4. I'm not for sure, because I was, like, going into kindergarten.
I would say 4. 4 or 5. 4 or 5, by the voice.
If you listen to her voice, that's where it is.
That's where she's talking from, 4 or 5. She sounds like a 4 or 5-year-old.
Oh, my God.
Well, that's what happens. The one thing we've noticed, at least with women, is that when they've been traumatized severely, they just stop. The development becomes arrested, and that is well known to be the case. But strangely, their voice seems to stop evolving, too. And so they sound like someone who's that same age. Almost, I don't know what that is. I wish somebody could explain that to me. Because no one, listen, believe me, I've gone out there and tried to search out an explanation for this, and it ain't out there. As though our brain walls off to further development. It's too painful to continue to develop. I don't know what it is that, why God arranged it this way.
I don't know. Maybe it's so me and you could separate them.
From the rest? Yeah, it could be. So, Emily, what's up?
Well, I was, my neighbor, he was like, I'm not making fun of him, but he was like mentally retarded.
Yeah.
Oh, shoot, my phone's going out.
Finish up quick.
Okay, my neighbor was like mentally retarded, and he, took me and kidnapped me and locked me in his closet, and he had like a bunch of cats. He was like obsessed with cats.
Cats? And, CATS?
Yes.
Yeah, and he raped me for a couple of days, and then my parents, his wife came home.
Wow.
And I started crying, and she.
Oh no. The phone.
Interestingly enough, that the audio noise that I just heard was more traumatizing
than her being
to
raped.
Me than the rape. Yes, I know it doesn't sound fair.
Your nasally drone's going to stay the same forever. Oh, my God. Oh,
All right. Poor Amanda with the battery and the phone. So here's the... that wasn't Amanda. That was... who the hell
she's
was
gone.
That?
Emily.
Emily. Here's the thing. I guess her question was going to be that her parents did not know she was raped.
They knew she was kidnapped. They must have, because she must have been missing. She just started telling us it had been a couple of days, and she was in the closet
like
with the cats and all this stuff. And
I think the fan, she certainly shouldn't feel bad telling them about it. They must have hopefully gotten her some treatment for having been kidnapped, I would hope. But we can tell just by talking to you that there's still some,
yeah,
what's called implicit memory, that the event is sort of etched into your biology.
Just being locked in a house for 3 days, yeah, where there's a bunch of cats is trauma enough,
right,
for therapy.
Yeah. And that implicit memory, meaning you may not have even explicit bothersome thoughts about it or screen memories where you actually remember the details of the event, but it has left its residual on your biology. And that can be undone with treatment. That can be helped anyway.
All right. Let's talk to Kathy.
And I'm Ann. This is a good call.
Who's
interested in this.
28?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's up there, Kathy?
Well, I've listened to you guys for a few months, and I was curious about your all's.
Hold on a second.
That's a good question.
I know, but I got to go on this rant just very
Uh-oh.
Quickly. Very
Hold on,
quickly.
Kathy.
If there's anybody who's listening to this show that designs computer font, please, 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 for the love of Christ, leave the dot out of the center of the zero.
Yes.
Because from anything, if you're further back from the screen, if you're more than 35 inches back from the screen, it becomes an 8.
Yes.
Now, I know what the dot is. The dot is so I don't confuse it with the letter O.
Yes.
But let's really examine the dangers.
Yeah.
If something says 12, and then there's a 0, and then there's an 8, would I think it's 1208, or would I somehow get stumbled on this 0
Let's
part?
Even do a risk assessment. If you mistake a 0 for an 8, isn't it a bigger, more common, significant issue than mistaking a 0 for an 0?
Yes, it is. And that's why I would ask a young Brian, our phone screener, to now replace every 0
with an 0.
With an 0. In effect, doing exactly what they were trying to prevent. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's do that. And then I'll not have to look at that goddamn thing that I think is an 8, except it's a 0, but we put a dot in the middle of it. Jesus Christ. Is there a shape difference between the two?
Uh-oh.
All right. Now I'm mad. All right, let's talk to, who are we talking to? Kathy?
Yeah.
Kathy.
Yes.
Oh, my God, with the 0 and the dot in the middle of it.
Go ahead.
Well, good luck with that. You guys are great. And it's not so much a question, really, is what's the deal with saying GD and Jesus Christ, but you don't let people say S-H-I-T? I don't get that. I mean, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, because know you're not even supposed to spell it. There's a part of me that wants to alert Anderson, but his back's to us. Oh, Anderson, who cares?
Oh, no.
Come on.
We'll tell people what she just did so they won't hear it.
She just spelled out the S word. And
the S-H word.
Yeah, you got to say S word or F word.
Okay.
Right, right. Yeah, so what's the deal with the using the Lord's name in vain? And the S and the F word.
Well, I'm like, oh my.
Here's the thing. When I got onto radio way, way back in the late 90s, the GD thing, the goddamn thing, not really acceptable. I remember having a few people talk to me about that, especially during the morning show.
Oh, really?
And certainly not on TV.
Oh. Uh-huh.
I like to think of myself as one of the early GD pioneers. I paved the way for future hosts who want to use the Lord's name in vain.
I remember when we were on TV, we couldn't say Hitler.
No, we could. Drew,
well,
really.
Somebody prevented us from saying Hitler. Remember that?
Don't screw that up.
All right.
I have explained this to you.
Stop
clinging to
it. I just remember people.
No, don't cling to it.
All right, keep going.
Every producer in TV is Jewish, and they don't like to think about Hitler.
All right.
And once in a while, I would bring Hitler up by saying, using him as a negative example.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm not a bad guy. I'm not a great guy, but I'm certainly no Hitler. And they'd say, stop talking about Hitler. And I'd say, shut up. I'm using him as a negative example. And that would be the end of the conversation, Drew.
All right.
Please, you can say Hitler on TV. So anyway, Kathy.
Yes.
Goddamn fell a few years ago. And now we can say it freely.
How did you get by doing that on the radio?
I don't know. I don't know.
Radio channels, I know day and night's got to be different, but what gives you permission to be able to do that at night versus radio stations during the day? Because they freak out if somebody says, you know, the D word.
Yeah. Well, it all depends where you are and who your program director is and what kind of music you're playing and what your audience is.
The reality is there are only 7 words you can't say on TV and radio. And they were invented by George Carlin in the 70s as a part of a comedy routine. But the Congress actually called him before the government and had him testify. And they used his 7 words that he had made up as the words you can't say.
Yeah.
And that's it. And it did not include GD and did not kill Jesus Christ. You could say those words.
And
they're not prevented. Well, now people might
Everything's going now. It's all going to fall.
I know. But great. I'm glad you're happy.
No, listen, I was watching the Anna Nicole Smith show on
Is that out now?
Yeah, it's out.
Is that good?
No, not really. It's all right, but not really. And she used the S word 3 or 4 times in a row.
And it got through.
Right there.
I mean, Ozzy's using the F word every other word.
Well, they're bleeping it out.
But like, you don't know that's what he's saying. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know, Drew, but I'm saying there's still a big difference between that.
Well, they let it go through, the S word. I mean, actually
that's
go through.
That's what I'm saying. All right. I'm saying that.
And your little caller that said she was kidnapped by the 14 guys or whatever.
Yeah.
I think that's totally bogus.
No, it wasn't bogus.
No?
No.
No.
She didn't sound upset at all.
But that's something that happens to people that have been severely traumatized. They seem very blasé about it.
Well, that's my line of work, I don't buy it.
What's your line of work?
Law enforcement.
Yeah, but listen, Kathy, here's how we always know the difference between people that are lying and the people that aren't. By the way, I think Kathy's lying about being in law enforcement. You ask them stuff like, did they catch these guys? And they answer with, they caught one of them. And has he gone on? How did they catch him? Or what's keeping him up? The girl who took the money testified that she was taking money off of these.
14-year-olds can't come up with that kind of detail.
No, not only that, but it doesn't mean anything. That's how you know you're getting the truth. When someone tells you something boring, that means it's the truth.
Right.
If you're making up a story, you go, did they catch any one of the 14 guys? Nope. They're still out there. You know, they're bikers. They may have went to Mexico.
Yeah.
Or they caught all of them.
Yeah.
And my dad shot him and killed him.
Right.
Something good. Not they got one guy. Did you go to trial? No.
Yeah.
You know, if it's boring, it's the truth.
Not only boring, it's
it's life.
It's also doesn't make immediate intuitive sense. Like, what do you mean you didn't have to testify? Well, this other guy, I would not have thought of that.
Here's the point, too. You go to a movie, that's fiction.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
Right.
The drive home for the movie, that's boring. That's life. Huh. That's how you can tell the difference. The conversation you have with the old lady driving home from the movie that goes something like, Shrifty's ice cream used to be 15 cents, and now it's 60 cents.
What happened to that weird little scooper they used to have?
Yeah.
The cylindrical ice cream. Yeah. What happened to that?
I don't know. But they keep them in water, I'll tell you that.
Hot water.
That conversation, that one, that's real. That's real. The one where Ben Affleck has to stop the nuclear warheads, a suitcase bomb from making from the farm, that's exciting. That's made up. That's how you know.
Yeah.
That's how you know this show's so real.
But anyway, Kathy, after 10, there's something called a safe harbor where people are allowed to do different things as long as it pertains to what you're talking about.
Celine?
Colleen.
Colleen.
There we go.
All right,
hi.
Colleen.
Yeah,
you're
hi.
28.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Huh, interesting.
It sounds like she's opening a bag of Fritos before she got on the phone. All right, I put Colleen back on hold for a second, and she can get her S together,
Jason,
as we like to say. Jason?
Hello?
16?
Hey, guys, what's up?
What's happening, Prada?
Yeah, hey, what's going on, Adam?
Hey,
first
feeling
of all,
good.
I have to say, Adam, I love how you just go off.
Oh,
that's
thanks.
Awesome when you go off on stuff.
It's awesome.
Thank you. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, that's what it sounds
that's
like.
That's what it sounds like to me. Absolutely.
Yeah, Andrew, I really respect you, man. You're awesome.
Thanks, Jason. What's going
anyway,
on?
I'll stop BSing here.
Yeah.
Okay, about a week and a half ago or a week ago or so, I went to a rave, and I met this girl there, and, you know, we were both using X, so it was kind of, you know, weird, but we got to talking, and...
You were both on ecstasy?
Yes, we were.
All right. Is this something you do often?
No, I've only used it about 4 times.
All right. Please try to stop. You're really at a threshold where it can start to affect you, so...
Okay.
All right. You understand that, right? It damages the brain and stuff.
Okay.
You don't know that?
Well, I've heard that, but...
I, as God is my witness, it does. I've seen it over and over and over again. So okay. Just...
All right, well, thanks for that advice.
All right, what's up? So what happened?
But anyway, my question is, I'm wondering if, like, fetishes, or I guess it's a fetish, but I'm not sure, can, like, repeat themselves. Here, let me... Okay, I'll give you the rest of the story. We basically were talking, and then we went into a back room, and, you know, I started giving her a massage and stuff, because that's, you know, basically what you do when you're on X, I guess. And basically she was, like, really concerned about her feet, and to me that's kind of gross out. So,
you mean she wants you to rub her feet?
Well, yeah, rub, lick, massage, anything.
Oh, lick.
Well, no, wait a minute.
Big difference between a rub and a lick.
Yeah,
on the
I
foot.
Mean, most women, would you agree, Adam? Women have a thing about their feet. Most women. They're into shoes, they like their feet rubbed, they have a pedicure. Yeah.
Cuticles. Yeah, I mean, look at it this way. And by the way, again, more evidence. They're getting paid 70 cents on the dollar. They think it's not enough. I think it's too much. How many hours do you think you got tied up total in your toenails?
Myself?
Yourself, your lifetime. 8 minutes?
In my lifetime, yeah.
Yeah. Women have weeks, months, years tied up in just the toenail.
Yes.
To us... Totally useless part of the body.
When they get the toenails done, they get little massages and stuff. And that's part of the deal.
I'm just saying, how can you get stuff done when you're that wrapped up in your own toes?
Yeah.
Yes, they do love the toes, Jason.
Yeah.
But the licking, that's a different part.
Yeah.
There you went off again. That's awesome.
Thanks, bud.
Yeah. But anyway,
I'll tell you what.
Don't encourage him, goddammit.
I'll tell you what we're going to do, Jason.
Yeah.
We're going to install a little light. It's going to be like the bat signal. It'll be at your place. You're in Idaho.
Yeah.
We'll put it by your nightstand. And you just tap on it. We'll put a red light in here. And whenever I see that light go off, I'll just go off on whatever the last word I was talking about is.
Right.
All right?
Yeah, they didn't tell me anything about...
No, we're gonna have that installed.
Yeah, okay, that's great.
Okay, good times.
But, yeah. Anyway, okay, basically, we were in there for about, I don't know, 30, 45 minutes. And at the time, it felt good because, you know, we're both on X, so it felt good. And then... later on, thinking about it, it was kind of gross out. So I'm wondering if it's bound to, you know, happen again if I
All right, clarify this for us. Again was the word, I believe.
Again?
Yeah.
Once and again, that TV show. Jesus Christ, what's up with that?
Again, that's your favorite word. High school football, again.
Oh, you mean?
Ceramics, again.
Oh, you mean I can talk about
your
same
mom,
topic again?
Again rings true for me.
No,
I
got to rant on something that has the word again in it.
I see. Okay, got it.
In the title.
All right, once and again.
Born again Christians. Oh, my God. Once and again. Go ahead, Drew. What am I missing? Played again, Sam.
Ooh, good
There's
one.
A Woody Allen.
Well, now we can talk about something worthwhile.
Yeah. All right. So... Well, listen, he needs to relax.
I still didn't get whether or not the foot went in the mouth. I need to know that.
He said he was sucking. He was licking.
No, hold on. Did he say that?
He said he's licking.
Jason.
Yes, the toes went in the mouth.
The feet go in the mouth?
Yeah, well, yeah.
That was her idea?
Yeah, it was.
You know, I wonder if that just wasn't because she was on ecstasy and that normally it would just be a foot massage. You're going to be doing foot massages, Jason. Get ready for that. That's part of being a male.
What is it that where women, once you hook up with a woman, she thinks she's entitled? Really, honestly, 150 massages for every one you get. Like, it once in a blue moon, I get a gift certificate for a massage, always claimed by the old lady.
Of course.
Grabs it every time.
Yeah, yeah.
It's theirs now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you wouldn't want that. They're kind of right, though, you know.
We may not have time for it, but it doesn't, and we may not let ourselves enjoy it sometimes.
It doesn't do
or
as much
make
for
us. Time for us. No. I
Ooh, you telling me something here?
Yeah.
Ooh,
I'm going to tell you something. Yeah.
I thought there was some potpourri in your bathroom when I went in there.
I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to say that a guy gets as much out of and enjoys a massage as much as a woman. We just don't let ourselves get to the mindset where we actually go spend money and drive down and go do it. I could argue that we'd enjoy it more because I get one massage about every 19 months, whereas every woman I get averages one every 11 to 14 hours. You know what I mean? How many massages does your wife get compared to the ones you get?
10 to 1.
Easily,
yeah.
So how could she enjoy it?
She doesn't get a lot, though. She doesn't.
No, just 10 to 1. Please, who are you kidding? She travels on a massage table. I've seen her. They put wheels on it and they roll her around like a gurney so she can actually be worked on the way to the massage place. On the way to Burke Williams, she gets a massage.
Nice.
Drew, seriously, though, you enjoy it because you haven't had any hands on you in a year and a half. Yeah. I mean, rubbing your neck and everything. I don't think they enjoy it more. They're willing to accept it.
I think you're right.
You don't accept
it. There is that.
You will not accept it.
There is, but not only that, I think there's also that thing about them spending time on themselves. That's all part of that whole hair spa, spending time experience that I hate. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like very uncomfortable.
I'm telling you, massage guy showed up at the man show a few days back. I got a nice 15-minute workover. Pop some things, crack some things, pulled the leg.
You're gay. You're gay. You're gay.
Pop the socket and snap the neck. Come on. Felt like $1 million. Million.
Make that guy come over here.
All right. All right, after this.
LoveLine. LoveLine. 1-800-LOVE-191. Back in a minute.
Hey, everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. All right, let's hop back on the phone and talk to Nikki. Nikki?
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, here's my problem. When I was 15, my mom's new husband, he molested me. Mm-hmm. And ever since then, I'm 20 now, and I should have got over it by now, but I still can't.
Had anything happen to you before you were 15?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
Did anybody physically abuse you ever?
Well, when I was real little, he would hit me.
All right, so there's a couple things then, right?
Who would hit you? The stepdad?
Well, at the time when I was little, he was just her boyfriend.
Ah.
All right, yeah, so this guy's been abusive to you in multiple ways.
What a delight.
That's towards my mom, yeah.
All right, but the being physically abused is probably what set you up to be the victim. If you had not been so abused when you were younger by him, you probably would have been able to fight him off, or you wouldn't have cooperated with him in quite the same way, I suspect. And I'm not saying you'd cooperated, that you willfully cooperated, but...
Well. All right, but it's academic.
But the point is that there's going to be a lot of things you're going to feel about men and intimacy. They're going to be profoundly disturbed now because of these.
How long did this molestation go on?
For like a year, and he would like threaten me if I told anybody I would go in a foster home, and he would kill my mom.
Oh my God!
Stuff like that.
What? And where is he now?
Well, actually, we went to court in 2000, and he was found guilty, but
he
didn't get jail time. He got house arrest. But a week after he died, so.
What did he die of?
Because he's been suffering with his liver all his life.
Fantastic.
He got a new one, but it failed.
Oh, who gave him a new one?
Well, now, wait a minute. What was his liver disease from? Hepatitis C, right?
From drinking all his life.
Right.
All right, there we good. Go.
Do you use drugs yourself?
Where's my bourbon?
Huh?
No.
Alcohol?
No. No, I don't do anything.
Right, good.
So how's your life going now?
I don't know. I have a lot of trouble with guys.
I'm sure of that.
Yeah.
And I'm sure of that.
I'm still never did sex yet, so.
Yeah.
So you're a virgin.
Right.
Okay. Well, listen, here's what I want to say. A lot of people who have been through what you've been through have troubles, but they're different kinds of troubles. It's not like they can't get next to a guy. They get next to way too many guys.
Right.
And they end up doing porno movies, and their life becomes a mess, yeah. Okay? Mm-hmm. Your life may be difficult as well, but at least you've gone the other way. You've stayed away from it, which is not easy for you emotionally, but in terms of, you know, you could have AIDS, have had 1,000 partners, and there'd be 150 movies on the shelves now with you starring in them.
Yeah.
You and a German Shepherd.
So, look, Nikki, there's plenty of people out there that are going to help you with this. This is the kind of thing that responds to treatment. You ought to look into it and, make things better. This is not...
Oh, yeah, and then, look, this is the kind of thing where there's lots of groups. It's well-studied. They have a good model for this. You can talk to other women. I mean, I don't know where you start. I don't know if you open the front of the phone book.
Well, Yeah, I mean, if she has a doctor, she can get a referral to a therapist, or she can look up, there's something called Emotions Anonymous, which is a 12-step group, and there are other women support groups out there, rape support groups, that sort of thing, that would be a place to start.
Hmm. I thought Emotions Anonymous backed up Smokey Robinson.
They did.
In, I think, they 65, 66.
Just ripped off the name.
Okay. Yeah. Let's, I know we got to take a break. Ellie?
Hi.
Hey, you're 24?
Yes.
You're a masseuse?
Yes.
And guys really like her?
Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
Like they pay you $250?
An hour.
$250 an hour?
Wait a minute.
To come to them.
What kind of...
Oh, you come to their happy release? Or... Yeah, hold on. $250. I'm going to need something. I might need to just... $250, I'm going to need to at least, like, rape your duffel bag. You know, whatever you bring.
Your bean bag.
They bring the table. All right, let's take a quick break. We're going to talk more about massage after this. No, wait a minute. Let me do some good radio. They come to your house. They tell you to get naked. They rub oil on your back. I call that prostitution. Anyone who's got an argument with that, phone up 1-800-LOVE-191. All right? Prostitution, baby. You drop trowel. They rub you down with oil. I call that a prostitute. 1-800-LOVE-191. You got a problem with that.
All right, guys. Here's the deal. Looking to hook up? Call the Dateline. Sick of wasting time with the wrong person? Call the Dateline. One call is all you need to make. Call the Dateline.
1-877-889-DATE. You know what I'm saying out there?
Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back on LoveLine.
Hey, everybody. LoveLine. I'm Adam. That's Drew. I came up with a good idea during the commercial when I was going on a minor rant about airport parking.
Minor rant?
I've had such
an
asshole.
It's been a long time since I've seen you jump up and down.
I was jumping up and down. But I wasn't jumping up and down like I was, like the yelling was propelling me up and down. I yell, and then I jump up and down, and then I yell some more.
Kind of like chimpanzee, you know, when they a little squawk, and then they jump up and down, right?
I was telling Drew, I got to go to the airport tonight.
Did you see this, Ann?
I got to go to the airport tonight and take a, Drew, don't make Ann turn the TV off. How dare you? Drew.
She's watching Crankyaggers. Give me a break.
No, she's not.
Are you going to the airport tonight?
Yes, I'm going to the airport tonight.
There's a bomb scare at the airport.
Oh, at Delta,
now.
In fact. It's at the Delta terminal.
That's breaking news. That's what we're watching.
Oh, really?
It's at the Delta terminal.
Interesting. At the Delta terminal.
Right? Terminal 1, right?
Oh,
because, yeah, I heard about it in the way. It's 1 or 2. It's...
I'm supposed to be flying out of the Delta terminal tonight at about 1:35. So, yeah, check it out. Keep me posted. But more pressing than the bomb threat at the Delta terminal that
parking.
I'm supposed to go to is parking. And what an incredible... Now, those of you listening around the country, I imagine, unless you're in New York, don't know what it's like to really be bent over and severely raped and brutalized by parking. And all forms of parking, whether it's parking tickets, the parking personnel, or the valet guys or whatever. Here's what I'm talking about. I went to LAX. I went to the airport, and I was going to park in the main parking structure. And I had a flight, and you know me, I like to cut a little bit close. But I got rolled in about 45 minutes before the flight was going. I was going to Vegas. I didn't have to check anything. It was like Southwest, and this is before 911, so there wasn't so much trouble. I rolled in. Every spot was filled in this thing that's five stories high and 3,000 acres big. And I drove in a circle for 45 minutes. And then when I attempted to leave, they would not let me out because I owed them money. I owed them money because I pulled the ticket, drove around for 45 minutes in their goddamn parking structure, could not find a space that they let me into. So then when I left, they charged me. And I was telling Drew that also they like to do the 20-minute increments and round up. Now, they got a time clock there. They could certainly calculate it, but of course they round up. Meaning, if you go to park somewhere and you're there for 41 minutes, you pay for an hour. Isn't that remarkable that it favors them? Here's what I would like everyone within the sound of my voice to do, and I swear to Christ I will do it myself, Drew. Next time that happens, where you're there for 41 minutes and they charge you for an hour, I would like you just to stay where you are. I would like you to tell the sea sucker in the booth
fill out your hour.
That I got about 19 minutes I got to burn here, Pedro, so I ain't going anywhere. What do you think of that? Let people back up and then say, look, here's the deal. I'm not paying for an hour for 41 minutes. I wouldn't pay anybody I paid by the hour for 41 minutes. I'm not rounding up. That's not the way I'm going to do it. You're right. I got 19 minutes to kill. So if you don't want me to hold up the line, maybe you can clear out some of these people that are parked behind me, and I'll see if I can maneuver my way back into some sort of parking space, or perhaps I'll just drive around aimlessly for the 19 minutes. I would love everybody to do that because they would immediately abolish this thing.
Yep.
They can just charge you the time that you're there for. How can you get ripped off if, as a company, you charge for the amount, the actual amount? You don't add on 30%. You just add the amount of time that they were there. That's what people pay for. And I would love it if everyone just sat where they were and didn't move for the remaining 12 minutes or 18 minutes or whatever it turns out to be.
Well, Adam, we live in a time when that would be a difficult calculation. I mean, no one has anything other than a pencil and a paper. In a pad of paper, they have to calculate that.
Yes,
longhand.
Yes, I would just love that. I would love that. And somebody call me, by the way. And also, I don't want this show to turn some Consumer Report show, but you can beat the S out of people and eventually get them to see it their way. I would like to find out, for instance.
Well, that's how society functions, right? It's sort of an implicit contract amongst.
I would like to find out, for instance, what the window for the guy who comes over to install your cable is these days. Uh-huh. I imagine it's down significantly from the 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. window they used to hand out back when they were the only game in town.
Yeah, yeah.
And by the way, if anyone who's listening to me owns it or operates or works for a cable company, kiss my hairy ass, you sea suckers. You get exactly what you deserve. Oh, we'll be over in about 11 hours. You just take the day off work. I'm like, listen, I've scheduled this thing a month in advance. You can't give me a window? Yeah, 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. We should have a guy out there. Oh, you don't like it? Why don't you invent your own cable? Why don't you create your own programming? Well, guess what? We got it now. It's called satellite, and you guys are out of work. Blow me. Can't stand that. Drew?
Ellie?
Hello?
Hi.
Drew, I got to do a consumer show. I'm angry.
Oh, get into that. That's good. So, $250 an hour for a massage, and guys are your customers, right?
Correct. Sometimes females, but mostly
sometimes
men.
Females.
$250.
Yes.
And is there a happy release?
Go. No, there's not actually.
No. No sex?
Help him. No. No, absolutely not.
Are you talking to your dog?
No, I'm my little cousin, sorry.
Oh, okay, good. I was praying it wasn't your boyfriend.
No.
You've been whipped. So, and now isn't $250 about $1.50 more than the going rate?
I suppose that actually all the girls that I know that does, you know, that offer to do it, it's $250.
Everybody.
And there's no happy release. These are guys with lots of money that are just, you know, they want the convenience of someone coming to their house that is attractive and giving them a massage with some great smelling oil.
Oh, the attractive now. See,
yeah.
It's
all right, but let me.
It's starting
to become. It looked like a kaleidoscope at the beginning, and now it's really just like when I would watch slides at my grandmother's house. You know, it's just a little
out of focus.
Yeah, it needs to be cleaned up a little bit. So you're attractive.
Yes.
And these girls are attractive.
Yes.
And part of it is, while it's not prostitution. Although I say, you go to someone's house, you take your clothes off, you drop down, blah, 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 blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah, blah,
Yes.
Right. And what I've said before, you come over to a guy's house, you tell him to drop trowel, now you oil him up. I call that prostitution.
Wait a minute. No, you're a licensed therapist.
She was going to talk.
Hello?
Am
I still on?
Yes. Yep. You're a licensed massage therapist?
Yes. No, I'm not. I'm not, actually.
You're not licensed.
Did you train anywhere?
Nope.
No. How did you get into this business?
There's websites all over that offer this.
That offer what?
Massage.
Yeah, massage.
Yeah, but most of those are...
They offer other things like, you know, escort. But I'm not under that category.
Well, are you working for a company?
No, I work by all I do is I pay them to put me on their website. My picture, my ad, and my
phone
number.
Oh, your picture. All right. Again, a little more clarity, a little more focus. So you're 24. You're attractive?
Yes.
Now, aren't you worried that some of these guys are going to get the wrong idea?
Or you're going to walk into something that you can't control?
I make it very clear when they call. They ask, you know, of course they ask, you know, what does the 250 include? And, you know,
right.
I'm very upfront about that.
Right.
And some of them want it before they go to bed. They want a massage.
Now,
you know, some of them want it in the middle of the day while they're about
to What do you wear?
It depends on the weather. I'm, you know, I live near the beach, so usually I'm in, like, a dress or shorts or skirt.
I mean, do you dress provocatively?
No, pretty casual.
Who are these guys? Are these old men, younger men?
I'm going to give a choice between Arab, and Arab.
Okay.
What's it going to be? A, B, or C?
Let's see.
I don't know. She's not going to admit to that.
Who are these guys?
No, a lot of them are attractive young guys that I would actually date. It's surprising that they would pay for that.
Don't they? Well, this is
the difference between guys and girls right here.
Okay.
Yeah, right?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
This is it.
This is it. This, yes.
This is it.
This is... You've touched on this completely, which is I have many, like, let's put it this way. Dave Duchovny and Richard Gere have probably gotten their fair share of lap dances.
Yes.
But there's no Julia Roberts or whoever the hot chick female is that's paying dudes to rub on them.
Right.
You know
they're
what I mean?
They're on there, yes. too. No, they're on but, there, too.
But, you do girls, too?
Yeah. There are guys on there, and there are guys that do the guys.
Guys that do guys.
Listen. First off, I'm saying lap dance. But here's the thing. Hot chicks aren't going to pay a dude $250 to work them over.
They don't have to.
That's right. That's
but
the point.
But
only ones with money will.
But the other thing is that the whole massage spa thing is not a sexual thing for a woman.
Right.
Really. Not in the same kind of... You know, provocative way. That would
No, it's a little sensual, but it's not sexual.
Right, right.
Guys don't even have sensual. Sensual was a word that was invented for women, by women. There's no such thing as sensual for guys. Women created the word sensual. I never really thought about it because it's sort of sexual meets natural. Sensual. It's like I have one nipple's hard. That's what sensual is. It's a way that women can feel good about having some juices flowing, but yet not acting on it.
It's not directed. It's not...
Yes, yeah. It was sensual. The waterfall, the bath salts, the whole environment. Men don't have sensual. Men have sexual or their sister.
Yeah.
But they're either in or they're out. But anyway, but basically what Ellie is saying is she has zero training. She looks good in a pair of shorts. She put her picture up on the internet. And guys call her over to the house to see what they can get away with. I got one more question. Ellie.
Yes.
Do they ever try to offer you more money for more?
Oh, absolutely.
All right. And I'm sure...
Some girls do. Some girls
all right. And
that.
I'm sure that happens quite often, right?
Yes.
Aren't you worried that that's going to create some legal issues for you?
No, she's not doing anything.
But I mean...
No, I've checked. I have many friends that are officers and
But
exactly what the line is.
Yeah.
All right, listen, here's how it works. You put a picture of yourself on the internet, you're a hot chick. You say, oil massage, soothing, sensuous oil massage, $250. Dudes look on the internet and they go, this chick's a hot piece of ass. Massage, I get it. I'll get her over to the house. Then they call her up and she's like, you understand? You know, you get naked, you get in your towel, but I don't get naked. And they go, okay, yeah, no, I understand. You know how guys are. Sure, baby. And then they come over, and the first thing out of their mouth is, you want a Zima? Are you cool? You want to smoke out a little bit? I mean, just to relax. You don't want a wine cooler? And then they come in, and they get about halfway in the massage, and the guy says, hey, you know, for another $250, maybe I could flip over. And she says, no, but it's too late. She's got the $250. That was what they agreed on. The guys think that something's going to happen. It's sort of like saying, I'm a hot chick. You can take me out to dinner and hold my hand for $250. A lot of guys who have money would bite on this, thinking, I'll get a little booze in her and I'll get her into bed. Don't worry about it. Meanwhile, she just keeps making the same $250 over and over again, is laughing all the way to the bank. Or as I should say, the skank. Thank you. All right. But she's not a... She's charging $250 because she's hot.
It's not a massage.
Ironically, you want someone with a license, you get them for $150 cheaper.
Isn't that crazy?
The guy who actually went to school, he needs $80. She needs $250 because she looks better in shorts than this guy does.
Isn't that nuts?
Well, I'm not surprised. Colleen?
Yes.
You're 28?
Yeah.
What's up?
I have a heroin addiction.
Good times.
And I'm kind of a functional addict, and I really want to get it out of my life, but I'm having a hard time with it because of the pain and because of the time it takes to detox.
Well, the detox, believe it or not, and Adam always gets angry when I say this, but it's the easiest part of getting off heroin.
Yes, I'm outraged.
The hardest part is what comes next. Detox, just 7 days of discomfort. And then what comes next is you're, you know, craving and preoccupied, and the whole addictive disease activates and, you know, changes your thinking and gets you back to the drug eventually. Not even eventually, usually rather quickly. So you have to be treated, and the treatment takes several months. Now, what do you mean you're a functional heroin addict? What does that mean?
Well, that it hasn't affected my
Of course it has. Of course it has. It may not in any kind of dramatic or overt way, but of course it has.
Well, she means she didn't get fired.
What is it you're doing? What kind of work are you doing?
I'm a nurse.
All right. So really, you're an impaired professional, and it's illegal and unethical and a very serious problem for you to be intoxicated and taking care of patients. Not even intoxicated, just under the influence of a chemical and taking care of patients.
Yeah.
So you have an obligation to do something about this. And I will tell you what, the nursing diversion programs are very, very effective in protecting you and getting taken care of this.
What's the nursing diversion?
Well, there are programs that are designed for professionals. There's a nursing diversion, a physician diversion, even the airline pilots.
Why do they call it program. Diversion?
It's to divert you from losing your license, really. It's what you do. They protect you if you do the program, and they prevent legal action and prevent you from losing your license. But you have to.
It's called diversion because doctors came up with it and they didn't want it to sound like rehab. They give it a nice little spin themselves.
No, I think it originally came from the legal system. Mm-hmm. It was to divert against going to jail and that kind of thing.
I'd look into it. I think it's a nice little euphemistic phrase. So doctors, they call it rehab for everyone else, but who wants to be slapped with that stigma?
Rehab is part of diversion. Usually, diversion is a bigger program.
Who cares what the subset of it is? As long as the big picture is called diversion.
All right,
sounds a lot better to be going to diversion.
Okay, well, she should go to diversion.
If I ever get strung out on anything, Drew,
diversion, I'll send to you.
That's right.
But look, you've got to do something about this, and it's going to require some focus. It's a disease. If you had any other disease, you'd take some time out, and you would treat it, and it's going to get you in huge trouble, and you may harm other people if you don't do something about it immediately.
Let me tell you what the reaction would be. Watch. I'll give you an example of how it works. Did you hear? Adam's in rehab. Oh, Christ.
It's about time.
That's tough. Did you hear? Adam's in diversion.
What, did he get a traffic ticket? What
do tell.
Diversion.
Oh, would you shut up? All right, where are we?
Yeah? Amanda.
Amanda?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, hold on. I don't like her attitude. 99 minutes? 99 minutes she's on hold. She angry?
For being on hold so long, probably.
Amanda?
Hey, Yubi?
Hello?
You angry?
No. I was listening. I was about ready to hang up. My head's starting to hurt.
All right, hold on.
I'm intrigued. Wouldn't the reaction be, oh my God, finally, as opposed to, eh, I was just about done with you a-holes.
Well, now she's made it to 100 minutes on hold. Let's try this one more time. Hey, Amanda.
Hello.
Oh, I'm going to need just a little more ass kissing, baby.
Excuse me?
I need you to kiss my ass just a little bit.
No.
No?
I'm not angry.
All right.
You're not angry? And try it again. I don't think she heard you. Give her one more chance.
Hello?
Amanda?
Is that your name, Amanda?
Hello?
Is your name Amanda? Is your name Amanda?
Hello?
What's going on there, Anderson?
I don't think she can hear. I'll put her back on hold. We'll try to work this out. She seemed to be able to hear us initially.
Yeah. Well, here she's back. She's back.
You're angry? She's back?
No.
No. Amanda?
Hello?
Amanda?
Hello?
Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Okay.
Listen. The response of hello? Hello? When someone is saying your name, does not really get you any closer to the part where you think they hear you, is it?
Hello?
Watch. Try it on me, Drew. Try it on me. Just
Adam?
For fun.
Adam?
Hello?
Adam?
Hello?
Adam?
Hello?
Can you hear me?
Hello? Oh, yes.
I'm so intrigued by this.
Amanda? Amanda?
Yes.
Oh.
Much better.
Why are you so angry, baby?
Angry? I'm not angry.
All right. What's up?
I called in an hour, or like 100 minutes ago, because I had a dream about two and a half or three weeks ago about my little sister. I had a crush on her.
Mm-hmm.
And she was here in my house with me and my fiance, you know, having a threesome. And I talked to my mom a couple days later, you know, I didn't tell her anything.
Smart.
And she said she thought that it would be a good idea for Tiffany to come over, for my little sister to come over.
Mm-hmm.
How did this threesome come about?
Well, she had a dream.
Oh, a dream about it.
She dreamt of a threesome. She's like the white, slutty Martin Luther King.
Thank you.
She had a dream, Charlie.
I see.
Jesus Christ.
I couldn't make the... My brain wouldn't make it. I was so busy with the threesome part. This is what college gets you?
This is college, everybody.
Pay attention.
No.
All right. Let me do the questions here. Drew, I'll let you get around that. I have a dream thing. This was a dream.
I didn't think about that.
Was this only a dream, or do you actually have some interest in your younger sister?
I don't know. I'm not sure yet.
Right. The jury's still out.
What is it?
I got the same thing with my sister.
But what happened, Amanda? Come on.
Amanda, what horrible atrocity must have happened to you growing up?
None.
Nothing?
Oh, come on.
No sexual or physical abuse?
Uh-uh. No one ever hit you?
Nope.
You were not forced to watch Mama's Family?
Mm-mm.
Or Small Wonder?
Nope.
No. Well, I'm out of answers. And do you say you have a fiance now?
Mm-hmm.
How old is he?
He's 19.
19. And why are you two going to get married so young?
Well, I don't know. We're just into each other.
Where's your dad?
My dad? I don't know.
Why did he leave?
I don't know. My mom and... He just got divorced.
Why?
Whenever I was like 4.
When you were 4. Was he doing anything to you kids at that point?
Uh-uh.
Do you still stay in touch with him?
Well, actually, it was like 15 years. I just talked to him over spring break last year.
What was that like?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, by the way, hold on a second. Amanda's calling from Florida.
Yeah.
And this is one more stone in the hopper of why I hate Florida, which I ironically I'm flying to in the next 2 hours.
What
by
are you
the
going
way.
To Vero Beach or something? What are you doing?
Yeah, I'm going to Florida and then I'm going to like Bahamas.
But
Florida, yeah, yeah. There's and she's by the way considered a scholar.
Yeah,
by
but I
most
don't think
Floridians.
I don't think children are allowed to have two parents in Florida.
Amanda,
what?
So. Where does this bizarre and unnatural attraction that you have for your younger sister come from? Because this is as unnatural an attraction as there is.
Is it?
Well, one of my best friends that I've known for, well, since 95, 94, something like that, she's a lesbian. And she's, like, one of my best friends.
Did she do something to you when you were 10 years old?
Oh, no.
11 years old?
No.
You've never done anything with her?
Nope.
So what's this have to do with your best friend?
No, I don't know. That's just about the only place I can think of that I got these feelings from.
All right. Well, here's the thing, Amanda. I don't know what's up with you, and there's not enough hours in the day. The good news is you can meet me at the airport in Orlando. And during my layover, I'll be more than happy to have a little sit-down with you in the smoking lounge. Okay. Here's the thing. Do not have sex with your younger sister. I know it seems like an obvious one, but it's bad. It's a very bad thing.
Don't have her eye over either. You sound terribly confused, and we can't quite figure out why.
And don't have any kids. You don't have any kids, do you?
No.
Okay. Look, no. Are you using birth control?
Yep.
What are you using?
What are you using?
Tetra something 28.
Good. Good enough.
Don't miss a pill.
Ever. And anyone who's living in the state of Florida, please listen. Do not have children.
Mm.
Please. And by the way, isn't Florida the place you escape to as a deadbeat dad? You don't actually have to have kids in Florida. People end up in Florida. I don't think anyone's born there.
I think those are the guys who we come across when we travel through Florida.
Oh, it is.
There's both. There's women left behind with kids, and there's deadbeat dads.
We get this sort of jovial, casual
driver
guy who drives driver us guy. In Florida who's never seen his kids.
Well, sees them at Christmas.
Oh, yeah, that's
right.
Goes
up to Michigan to see them.
That's right.
We got to go to break.
Oh, we do?
Yeah.
All right.
Hold on a second, Char.
We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
Hello? Is this LoveLine?
Call 1-800-LOVE-191. Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back.
You angry?
No.
Everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. All right. Char.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's 28.
Like Shari? Sherry?
Charlotte?
Char.
Char.
Yeah.
You're 28?
I am.
What's up?
I don't even know where to start. I have been with my boyfriend 7 years.
Uh-huh.
I had 2 kids from my previous marriage, and then we had a daughter together, so we have 3 total.
Why didn't you marry this guy?
I didn't marry him. He was just my boyfriend.
Why didn't you marry this guy?
We wanted to wait a couple years first, and then...
You waited a couple years, and you had a kid. Why didn't you marry this guy?
Well, right around the time we were actually planning it, he fell 30 feet, and... broke his back and had a traumatic brain injury.
Uh-huh.
And that just kind of put a damper on things.
Yeah, I can see that much.
And then the year following, we're just having really a lot of financial problems.
Yeah. How is he now?
I don't know. Because we spent 3 years together after the brain injury, and then 2 months ago, we got in a fight. Over, he's sick and tired of,
Well, hold on a second. Hold on. I didn't mean how is he at 11:30.
Okay.
Western Daylight Time. Yeah. Or Pacific Time. I mean,
overall,
how is he after
doing?
The brain injury?
Yeah. Actually, he recovered pretty good, actually.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good. So now...
Sorry.
That's all right. Now...
I just have totally lost... I don't know who he is anymore, is what I'm, you know.
Don't know what?
I don't know who he is anymore. And
because of the brain injury?
That's what I'm confused on. I don't know.
You said he broke his back.
Yeah.
Did he get on pain medications after that?
Yeah.
Did he stay on them?
For a while, but when they cut off his prescription, he pretty much stopped. But he would sometimes... ask some of friends for like Lortabs or something.
Right. Did he switch over to pot a little bit to kind of keep things going?
Not all the time, but he has.
All right. You see the deal here.
He was
moderate. I don't know what's going on, but what's the question?
Well, it's about me personally, but that's the issue.
What's the question?
I don't know how to deal with our breakup.
How long ago did he leave?
2 months.
And is he staying in touch with your child, or has he got a relationship with you at all?
A little bit, yeah.
Hold on a second. Is it Quaalude night, or are all the lines bad that are coming in here? Or it's repeat everything? Or like you ask a question, and there's like a slow 5 Mississippi, and then people answer?
I feel like I'm talking across a can with a string or something.
You'd be better off. Yeah, I don't know. Is it a bad line? I know the line hasn't been great, but I know
I have an ear infection. I can't tell.
People are kind of out of it tonight. Char?
Yeah.
Okay, can you hear us clearly?
Yeah, it keeps kind of doing a thing for just a second.
He left, and he left how long ago?
2 months.
Two months. Okay. And this is it for him. He's breaking up for good.
That's what he says.
And good. He's no longer going to be the father of your child.
I guess he's going to do the visitation thing and all that, but
has he been
keeping some of his promises.
Okay.
June and July, my two oldest had their birthdays, and he stood them up on their birthdays.
Okay.
He did come to me about 3 weeks ago and tell me that he was still attracted to me and that he wanted to have sex without feelings. But yet,
feelings. What a great guy.
What a dynamite guy. Well, he missed the kids. He missed the kid's birthday, but he made up for it by trying to have meaningless sex with Char.
That's nice.
Okay, listen, Char, I don't know what's wrong with you. This guy sounded like he was better before he got the brain injury.
Yeah.
But then he got hooked on some pain meds. She's doing a fair amount of defending on a guy. Yeah. And wants to get back together with a guy who sounds like a piece of ass.
He sounds like there's an addiction here. I just smell it. She wouldn't specify, but I know it's here. And he sounds kind of like a sociopath, you know?
Char sounds like she's ready to be his punching bag.
Right. Char, I would recommend go to Al-Anon or Co-Anon or codependent.
Co-Anon is for people are dependent on Jews.
I wanted to see if she's had an alcoholic father, just to kind of humor me.
Co-Anon. Yeah,
I got you. I got
Cohen
you.
To be a,
yeah,
be a Jewish
Co-Anon.
Name.
Co-Anon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you just nod your head a little, I'll know you heard me. I don't expect any laughter.
Of course not. No.
I just expect a little head nod.
Got it.
So I'm sometimes not sure if you heard me.
You know what?
Because you understand the reaction to a joke and the reaction to you not hearing me.
Same.
It's exactly the same. I mean, we had a camera going in here. So here's what I want. Here's what I want from you now.
You want a nod.
If you hear a joke, hold up one finger.
Yeah, I'll give you the, and keep talking.
No, don't point at me.
Just hold it
just
up.
One finger.
Got
like,
it.
Like, you know when you get your ears tested and they want to know what side the noise is coming from? Just give me the one finger.
It's a little
no
tough.
Smile,
little tough.
No nod. Nod would be an acknowledgement. Too much. The nod is too much.
Admittedly, it's a little tough because you got to remember what I hear is
blah 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 blah. I know, but if you hear blah 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 and it sounds like it's in a cadence that may
be
a joke, hold up the one finger.
Got it. All right, got it.
And then I'll move on.
I won't listen to the words, I'll listen to the rhythm. Got it.
Listen to the rhythm. If you hear the joke rhythm, hold the right index finger up.
Got it.
We'll move on. No eye contact.
No
head nodding.
No, don't worry.
And try to keep that frown on you.
Very easy.
Where are we going?
No. I want to know about her dad.
I don't
know. Just amuse me.
I don't want to know.
All right.
I don't want to know.
It's been heavy call night.
Char.
Yes.
Look, you got to get into one of these groups. You hear me? On behalf of your kids.
Okay.
And this guy's an idiot.
Could it be the abuse that I've been through in my past?
Yes.
Was your dad an alcoholic, too?
I didn't meet him until I was 11.
Was he an alcoholic?
No.
No? Well, he didn't
who abused you in the past?
Which one?
Well, where did it start? Who was the first? Who was the first? Char?
Yeah.
Who was the first?
A stranger.
And how old were you?
4.
All right.
Okay.
So this is where it's all coming
from. I did put a guy in prison, though.
Good. Excellent.
One of them out of the 5.
Oh, boy. Listen, Char. You're not damaged goods. You're fine. Your mission in life is to not let what happened to you happen to your kids.
Yes.
Okay?
Well, I agree with that. I watch it close.
Yeah, no, I don't mean just physically. I mean emotionally. Don't be brought up by a scarred mommy. I'm saying, get some therapy,
please.
You know,
it's interesting. I've seen a few children of Holocaust survivors, that kind of thing, in the last few months. And
hold on. Our listeners don't know what the Holocaust is.
It's World War II. For kids who, parents who were in World War II.
The children. Germans rounded up the Jews and attempted a genocide, which is like suicide, except for a kraut does it to you.
He does it to a whole
group. The same group. That's right.
It's amazing to me always how the tales of woe of the survivors of the wars and stuff get told through their kids.
Mm-hmm.
We're now adults now, and I'm dealing with an addiction and whatnot.
Right, right.
It's just unbelievable.
Right. And listen, if your parent was horribly traumatized, it's going to traumatize you as a kid.
It just gets transmitted. It's intergenerational transmission.
Yeah.
And we really have to learn to really work at not letting that happen. It means the parent doing some work.
I think the best bet, and my parents had gone through a little trauma, and I think they played it smart by not talking to their kids.
That was not a bad strategy.
My mom didn't know my sister's name until her 14th birthday, and it was just during the singing of the happy birthday that I think she caught on. If you talk to your kids, you'll screw them up. But if you don't say anything... Yeah, I mean, my parents treated their kids like they were captors.
Did I get it?
Drew, you heard something. Yeah, like they were captured pilots that had been shot down in World War II. You know, just they wouldn't give them any information. It's fine.
Yeah.
How are you going to screw someone up if you don't talk to them? Drew, give me the finger. Yeah. Not that finger, you a-hole. Okay. We'll take a break. We'll be back.
Hello. This is your radio. Radio. LoveLine will be right back.
Buddy, love line. Forget about that phone number. We don't need your stinking calls. We got enough, right, Drew?
Had enough. I don't know if we've got enough. A little bit different. Oh, wait.
Hold the finger.
Yeah, got it.
All right, you hear me?
Yeah.
Me and Drew have a new radio plan. When he hears me, he holds his finger up.
No.
Oh.
When I hear the rhythm that suggests a joke.
Right.
When I hear, blah, 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 blah.
Right, right. Because normally you hear this.
And once in a while.
But once in a while you hear blah 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 blah.
Oh,
blah 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 blah. So one more time, Drew. You ready?
Yeah.
You show. Now I'm going to test you. You give me the finger when you hear the joke rhythm. Okay. Blah 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 blah. Oh yeah, good, good.
I almost missed it.
He's got it. I know. You started to fall asleep.
Wow,
Adam.
Yeah.
You're 24. What's up?
I am, man. There's a lot up in this head. But anyway, basically, I'm 24. Never kissed a girl. Never been on a date.
Wow. Why never been on a date?
Drew, there ain't a big market out there for chubby, blind Jewish guys.
Blind?
Take my word for it.
What's the source of your blindness? What happened?
What's that?
His eyes are screwed up? Oh,
I think so. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Yep, there he goes. There's the thing.
Yeah.
What kind of blindness? What's the blindness from?
Corneal dystrophy, calcium deposits, glaucoma. I've had 29 surgeries so far.
Well, you're describing sort of symptoms there. What's the original problem?
Corneal dystrophy, deformed cornea is a birth.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're completely blind?
No, I can see enough to, get around. I'm not supposed to drive. Tried that once. Cops were pissed. But,
Well, I mean, you wear glasses. Can you go to a movie?
Glasses don't do me any good.
You don't wear glasses. Could you go to a movie? Do you go to movies?
I go to movies. I listen to them more so than watch them.
Can you see TV? Can you see television?
Yeah, I sit so close. I'm going to be glowing by the time I'm 30. But
now, what about losing some weight, getting into shape, sort of taking care of yourself a little more?
Yeah, the whole vision.
I don't have time for that. I work in politics, and I just don't have time. I'm working 12 hours, 7 days, man.
The vision part of your life shouldn't be a big factor to the ladies.
No.
It intimidates them. I think they see me as someone who's going to need to be dependent, and they don't want that. I understand that.
Wait a minute. They know
I'll tell you what intimidates them. Adam has a horrible attitude. I mean, he's sort of like cynical and bitter.
Yeah.
He's got all the good, he's got all the negative Jew qualities without the good ones. True. He's got the cynicism and the sharp tongue. Yeah.
I mean, you're smart, you have a good job, you're very active. What wouldn't they like?
Well, as I said, I think, you know, I don't care what I look like. I'm blind, you know, like, but I know that society cares what people look like, so I think that's a big part of it.
You know what, society doesn't really. It's that individuals do. Well, when they're searching for genetic, you know, the humans are out, we don't like talking about this, but humans are out looking for genes.
Yep.
That's what they're looking for. And you're smart, you work hard, and you've got a lot of significant attributes. You've decided that because you're blind, it's a handicap, even though I'm not so sure anyone really would. You insist you can't take care of yourself, even though you could.
I can and I do, but I'm saying that when people first look at somebody with, first of all, with a cane, they assume they're completely blind. So, you know, that you know, there's a lot of pity out there. There's a lot of help out there. I don't need, I don't want it.
Right.
But I know that when it comes for a woman who, if she, even if I was perfectly average weight, looking me into the bar, looking at the same guy without a cane in a bar, she's going to the other guy.
Well, forget the bar. Nobody does right at the bar thing. I mean,
I know, I know. And but listen, what I called about...
Yes.
No, well, hold on. That is untrue.
What?
Men act that way. Yeah. Women don't.
Yeah.
Women will gladly be with guys that are in wheelchairs, guys that have problems. As a matter of fact, women will be with a guy who's in a wheelchair faster than they'll be with a guy who has back hair. That's how smart women are. That's how open they are. They really would. Most women would date an attractive guy who is confined to a wheelchair than a guy with a lot of back hair.
There you go. So, Adam, what's your question?
Here's my problem. I've been desperate for a long time to be in love. I've been the idea of being in love.
Of course.
So my best friend, 15 years, long story short, about 3.5 years ago, I told her I loved her, which I had known since the first day of high school. She hasn't said a word to me since. Literally not a word. I'm now falling for another very good friend, and I'm dreading the idea of, and I'm a very straight-up person. I don't think
forget the being straight up with her. That will freak her out. What you got to do is first sort of romance her a little bit. To ask her, ask her out to dinner. Spend some time face-to-face and connect the time and see if it starts to go anywhere. Don't I wish I had a good analogy for this, but don't come out swinging. Don't try to overwhelm her or to try to, you know, jump into the game immediately.
Adam is an incredibly bitter and cynical guy who's been through a lot.
He's one of the guys in society. He's so smart, and society sees it that he's kind of smart.
Adam, listen to me. You have a horrible, wretched attitude, that women are not attracted to. It's not your fat gut. It's not your corneas. It's your horrible, cynical, self-defeatist attitude.
You need to adapt a bitter, hostile attitude like Adam. See, that's what they're really into, right?
You need to lose some weight, first off, because that's going to get in the way. And the part about being blind but doing, like, some driving and going to some movies and stuff, this does not sound like being blind to me. Ironically, blind people call themselves seeing impaired when they call this show, and we got a guy who's actually seeing impaired who's calling himself blind.
Visually challenged.
He doesn't wear glasses, and he can watch TV. Watches TV with no goddamn glasses, and he's blind? Oh, he's got to sit close.
I do, too.
Why don't we get a seeing eye dog? Seeing eye puppy.
Ooh, that's a good
seeing
good
eye
thing
puppy
to get people.
There's a good plan. He doesn't need one. He sounds fine to me. I'm not saying you don't have problems with your vision, but that's not the problem with the women.
Right.
Thank you.
Oh, Mary.
Jesus Christ. You know women. They'd never want to date that.
Mary?
Yeah?
What's
up? What's happening?
Well, he feels impaired. So they believe impaired when he feels impaired. The guy that can't move below the neck but feels empowered.
You know, the curse of the Jew, too, is when Jew guys get big, they get sloppy.
Mm.
When Goyim guys get big, they get husky. Young guys.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
All right. Mary, what's up? We have a couple minutes.
Hold the finger up. Drew knows what I'm talking about.
I was a victim of a traumatic event. It was a violent home invasion type thing.
Oh, my God.
And I was wondering, I don't have any insurance, so I don't have money for counseling or anything, which is what I'm told that I need to do. Is it possible to get over something like that without going to counseling?
What happened?
my little brother was, he was selling pot out of my mom's house. And I went over there one day. I don't live with them, so I don't have to worry about that. But I went over there one day, and I answered the door, and these two guys came to the door, and they pushed their way in. I'm getting all freaked out. They basically, like, shoved us down the hall with guns to our head and, like, put us in the bathroom and kind of, like, kept us there. My little brother's bedroom is across the hallway, and he came out with a baseball bat and, like, swung at them. And he ended up getting shot once. It was pretty bad. Anyway, he went to the hospital. I mean, he's fine now and everything, but it was pretty traumatic for me.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say the two guys breaking into the house, non-Jew, non-Jewish, both of them. I know it sounds incredible. Drew, finger up. Yes, non-Jew. Mary,
what about the victims of violent crime kinds of resources?
I haven't heard about anything.
There's
like
a lot of resources out there for people that have been victim of violent crime. Also, you live in Seattle. University of Washington is there. There's lots of prorated services through their mental health services. But I would call the police department and see what kind of availability there is in the state of Washington for victims of violent crime. I'm sure there is a bunch.
All right, Mary?
All right?
Okay.
All right. Take care of yourself.
Good luck.
You'll be fine.
Thank God everyone's okay. My God.
Yeah, statistically, she got it out of the way.
Yeah.
Whereas I go to bed every night thinking, when's my home invasion number coming up?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's like getting your wisdom teeth pulled or something, you know? I haven't got mine pulled yet. I got to think about it. And they're going to come in, and I got to get them pulled. They're going to get impacted. I think the same way with home invasion.
Blah, blah, blah.
Mary has checked her home invasion off the list.
Blah, 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 blah.
She can no longer be home invaded. That would be twice.
Huh.
I may get it tonight.
Hmm? Oh.
I'd actually like it tonight because I'm not going to be home. Is it home invasion if you're not there?
I think it's a... No, it's not a home invasion if you're not there.
Well, what are they invading then if you're not there?
Your
space
home.
Invasion?
Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah.
All right, guys, here's the deal. You're looking to hook up, sick of wasting time with the wrong person? Dateline. One call is all you need to make. Call the Dateline. 877-889-DATE.
Call the Dateline.
All right, that's the show, everybody.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
No?
Oh, Drew's finger's up. It means
was
he heard
that?
Me. All right. So, until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying, mahalo. You angry?
No.
This has been Loveline. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station.
The producer for Loveline is Ann Wilkins Engel. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.